Hi, everybody. Name is Bill Whalen. Glad to be here today. Glad you're all here to share this with me. I want to tell you a little something before I start my story. The last week or so, I thought a lot about my testimony, relationship with God, realized how blessed I was, how good He was, brought tears to my eyes more than once. So I need your help today with some little arrow prayers that will give me the calmness to get through this. I'm sure you didn't come here today to watch an old man cry. So let me get started with this. In 1963, God blessed me with a wonderful Christian wife, Naomi. And later, we were blessed with two great children, Dawn and Lori. Our children are both saved and their husbands as well. But during the early years of marriage, my focus was on working hard and providing for my family. Where'd it go? I did well in my career in the telephone industry and thought I was doing a good job of providing for my family. I started going to church with my wife and kids because it seemed important to them, but was uncomfortable for me. I often struggled just to remain for an entire service, knowing now that's spiritual warfare. But slowly, something sparked my interest to learn more about the Word of God. Sunday school was an option for learning more, and my attitude soon changed about attending church. I wanted to learn more and more. I sometimes thought people were spending too much class time having coffee and socializing. But then I learned how friendly they really were and how much they cared for Naomi and I. I fell into a comfortable routine of learning more about God and enjoying church. Things were good, and I felt that if I knew just a little bit more, I would be able to make a clear, quote, black and white decision concerning Jesus. Was he really who he claimed to be? And was I ready to take that leap of faith and accept him as my Lord and Savior without more proof? Maybe just a little more time and learning would be good. I attended church and Sunday school for years, seeking God and learning more about him, but always needing a little bit more. In my mind, I knew Jesus was who he said he was, but my heart was hesitant to act. But then in July of 1992, I had a dream. It was a dream of darkness. Now, I'm married to a woman whose father owned a coal mine in Pennsylvania, so I've been in the dark. When those lights are out, it really is dark, but not like this darkness. This was a darkness that was actually frightening. It felt like you could be consumed by it. And so I'm sleeping, I'm dreaming, and then there's a little tear in that darkness, and a wonderful white light began to show. And then a calm but warm voice said, "Bill, it's time to make a choice. It's either darkness or light." And I went back to sleep and got up the next morning knowing that I was a sinner and there was no way I would ever be able to pay for those sins, that Jesus had paid a terrible price for me on the cross, paid in full. He loved me that much. The next day, I did choose light and surrendered my life to Jesus as my Lord and Savior. On that day, I gained eternal life because he gave his life for my sins. But he was crucified, dead, and buried. But he arose from that grave, and my God is alive.
Amen.
I'm now 80 years old. I can't imagine living without Jesus. Since that day, some 30 years ago, I know with certainty that he was, is, and will always be faithful. Through good times and troubling times, he provides me the trust, peace, joy, love, and hope I so desperately need to finish my journey here on earth. So my favorite verse is actually half of Psalm 46:10. Be still and know that I'm God. And that's a good way to talk with him every day. And he will talk with you if you ask him.
Amen.
So I've used that time and time again. There's a lot of stories behind that. But given my story today, I hope there's somebody out there that's sitting on the edge of their chair. And I want to wish you sweet dreams tonight. that you have a dream just like I had. Thank you.
Wow. Amen. Thank you, Bill. Bill, your testimony, the word that comes to my mind is obedience, because you didn't say the year, but I saw over your shoulder, it was 1992 when you placed your faith in Jesus.
Check my notes here, Pat.
Right there, dude. All
right. You're right.
I'm not real good at arithmetic, but it's about 30 years, right?
Right.
So 30 years ago, you trusted Jesus as your Savior. And in obedience, you're getting baptized. I'm glad 30 years later, you're obeying the Lord and publicly testifying your faith. Amen?
Hey.
All right.
And thanks to you. You're the one that told me we needed to do this to be a member of the church. Now, I've been in churches in those 30 years, okay?
Yeah.
But that was never a command. But Jesus commands it.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for taking it off my lap, because it was Jesus who said it, not me, Bill.
Yeah, who are you gonna
okay.
argue with?
All right, you can argue with me. Don't argue with Jesus. Let's give it up for Bill. Okay.
Okay, thanks. Bill Whalen, based on your proclamation of faith before these believers, I am humbled and privileged to now baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.